Christmas came early. Hello, people of the internet, my name is Johnny, and welcome, finally, to Five Nights at Freddy's Clip. Ever since I did the FNAF Monopoly review, I have been wanting to get this, and now, I finally have it. So, what we're gonna do, we're gonna open this, we're gonna take a look at everything that is inside, the board, the characters, the cards, the weapons, the everything, and we're gonna review it. Now, we're not actually going to be playing it in today's video because I don't have any friends with me. Also, sorry if the video is like super echoey. That's just the room I'm in. I couldn't do it in my normal setup because I need a big space. I need a big table to show this baby off. Alright, so first up, let's take a look at this here cover. It's not that bad. Alright, it's really not that bad. This whole thing is based off of FNAF 2 for some reason. I don't know, I guess it has the most rooms and the most characters. You got Freddy on the front along with the newspaper, you got a little artwork down here, and then just Balloon Boy as well. Kishore, Balloon Boy's in here. A very minimalistic design, not gonna lie. You got FNAF right down here, you got Clue, the classic mystery game. So you combine the most mysterious board game with one of the most mysterious indie games of all time, and you're gonna have yourself one hell of a time. Oh, I didn't realize, Mangle's up here as well. I don't know how well you can see her, but she's there, or he's there. They are there. Yeah, I really don't think this cover art is really anything special. I was kinda hoping that they were gonna come out with a exclusive version of Clue, like what they did with Monopoly with the Twisted characters. But no, this is it. Before we open it, let's have a look at the back. Back's nothing too special either, just shows all the characters, the locations, all the weapons you can use to kill people. We'll get into all of this later on, but it's all there if you want to take a look at it now. Alright, let's read the description. The description says, an incident has occurred at Freddy Fazbear's Pizza. The Night Guard has gone missing, and the restaurant is on lockdown until you uncover exactly what happened at the infamous family diner. Take on the role of Withered Freddy, Toy Bonnie, Toy Freddy, Balloon Boy, Withered Foxy, or Toy Chica, and determine who killed the security guard, where he was killed, and what item assisted them. We're gonna get into all this later on when we actually open up the box, but right off the bat, I do have a few questions. mainly the characters and the items that you can kill the people with. I don't understand why they picked these characters and these items, but again, we'll get to that later on. Yeah, I think we are just about ready to open this sucker up. So let's do that right now! I'm not actually gonna do that. Ooh, that was clean. I got this knife as a joke, but it's actually working pretty well. Look at how clean this thing cuts. Damn, son! Alright, so, very neatly organized, USAopoly, or whoever made Clue. Thanks for doing that for us. Alright, so let's take a look at the board first, alright? Let's open the sucker up. God, I always hate opening these up, because I don't want to mess it up. Ooh! Spicy.
So this is the entirety of the Five Nights at Freddy's Clue board. Now, I've only played Clue, like, once in my life, so I don't know what these things do. But I do know that these are all of the rooms that the security guard could have been killed in. So, you can see we've got the party room 1, show stage, party room 2, the game room, party room 4, parts and service, party room number 3, kids cove, and the prize corner. There's also some shortcuts that you can take with the vents. Vent to party room number 4, vent to party room number 3, vent to party room number 1, and vent to party room number 2. I like the idea of the board being a security camera, because you can see the little recording icon there, and then the battery as well. Even though the battery in FNAF 2 is for the flashlight, so I don't really know what they're trying to go for with that. And then you've got Clue, Five Nights at Freddy's right in the middle. Unfortunately, you can't actually see Toy Chica on the show stage, but Toy Freddy and Toy Bonnie are there. And then the party rooms are exactly what they look like in the game. Party room 2, party room 1, party room number 3, and party room number 4 with the paper plate pals. The game room only shows the carousel, which is kind of weird, but whatever. Kids Cove shows some presents, not even Mangle in there. And then the prize corner, of course, shows the music box. Parts and service, we got Withered Bonnie just kind of like chilling right there, you know, look at him just chilling. Honestly, it's not a bad board. Again, I haven't played Clue very much, but I do like how it follows the theme of FNAF 2 very closely. It would have been nice to see it as the layout of FNAF 2, but I guess they can't really do that.
Then we have the rules, which no one cares about. I'm not gonna read them because the rules suck. But I find it funny that, notice anything similar? They reuse the exact same artwork. Then again, it is just a rule, so no one really cares about that. Alright, so this is actually interesting. You can see here, they actually give you the characters to make yourself. Hey, how we doing? Can we get up close here? So you've got green, Withered Freddy, you got red with Toy Freddy, you got yellow with Toy Chica, white with Balloon Boy, blue with Withered Foxy, and then purple with Toy Bonnie. Now, I've never done one of these before. I guess you just kind of like cut them out and fold them, put them in like the little plasticky things. I don't know, let's do it. So you fold them up and you put them in here. All right, so this is Withered Freddy. Don't know how well you're gonna be able to see him. Probably not well at all, great. It's just the basic render of Withered Freddy that you see everywhere, so nothing really too special there. Then we've got these two, again, same models you see everywhere. Toy Freddy and Balloon Boy. I will say the color choice for these characters is very interesting. Like, why is Balloon Boy, why is he the color white? I don't know. Toy Freddy red? What? The only one here that actually makes sense with the color is Toy Chica yellow. These models are just the basic ones we always see. So again, nothing really too special right there. Now, I believe these are new models of Withered Foxy and Toy Bonnie, but I'm not really sure. Toy Bonnie, I'm like 99.9% sure, but Withered Foxy, I don't know. Guys, tell me if these are new models. But yeah, like purple for Toy Bonnie, blue, like at least switch these two so Toy Bonnie's with the blue color. I don't freaking know what they were thinking. I will say that I like the idea of being able to build your own figures for the game. I like that.
Ooh, okay. Oh, I really like this actually. So this is the note card that you use to like figure out who did what, with what, where what, you know, stuff like that. And it's in the design of a newspaper clipping. That's really smart. I really like that. So you got like the who, where, what, and then you got like little notes down here that you can keep track of. Oh, I really like this. And there's loads of them. Like this is a lot. I'm not gonna count them all, but trust me, this is a lot. So you can play this game loads of times, which I love. Oh, okay, right. I think I know what this is. So this is where, again, I've only played Clue once in my entire life, so I'm not entirely too sure on what everything is. But I believe this is where you put, like, the character, the item that they killed the person with, and where they killed it, where they killed the Night Guard with, you put them in here. And then you actually play the game, you figure out who did what, where, and, like, with what, and then, at the end of the game, you open this up, and you see if you were right. So this is very simple, just Clue, Five Nights at Freddy's, little envelope, and then you've got the dice. All right, so these are actually very interesting because this die goes to 1 to 6, but then this one goes from 2 to 6, but it's got a little question mark on it. Again, I haven't played Clue that much, so I don't know what that means. I'm pretty sure it's like you get to ask someone a question or something. I don't freaking know. I'm gonna stop guessing. Ooh, and these are all the cards. Oh my god, this is gonna take a long time to go through everything. All right, so let's do the little tokens first, or like the weapons. I'll tell you right now, a lot of these are not weapons.
This is like the only thing that you can really call a weapon in this game. It's a little flashlight. Again, I don't know how well you're gonna be able to see it, but it is actually a pretty good flashlight. Ah, yes. I hate it when I get killed by balloons. Honestly, what were they thinking? You can't get killed by balloons. I do like it how it says balloons right here. I don't think you're gonna be able to see it, but it said, why am I so shaky? But it does say balloons, which I love. A Freddy mask. I don't know, you can suffocate in it, I guess? This is actually really well detailed. You can even see like all the eyebrows and you can see the teeth, the nose, even the eye holes. Are like, they're gone, so you can actually like put it on and see. Well, no, you can't, but you know what I mean. Very detailed. Ooh, so is this, the puppet's mask. Don't know how you can get killed by this, but again, it's very detailed. You can even see the little streaks of tears running down the mask. It's got the rosy cheeks, the lipstick. Something that's weird though is that only one of the eye holes is open so that you can actually see through. Don't know why the other one's filled in. Now this one's a little bit sloppy, but you can tell what it is. It's a little Freddy plus, or like little psychic friend Fredbear. Again, pretty well detailed, just a little bit sloppy. And then you've got the Puppets Music Box. Detail on this one is pretty well as well. You can see the ribbon up top, the ribbon going around the entire box. It's pretty nice. Again, don't really know how you can get killed by most of these things besides the flashlight, but they are pretty well made. And now what I believe to be the final thing we're gonna look at today, the cards. Like I said previously, these cards are the where, the who, and the what. All right, so we have a lot to get through, but most of them really aren't that detailed, though I really do love the design of them. So we're gonna go through these pretty quickly. All right, so here is Withered Foxy's card. As you can see, it's got his little picture right there, as well as a quote from Phony. And on the back, he's got a power-up? What? Flip this card over after using your power-up. Let's see, once per game, you may start two rumors on the same turn. So all of the characters' cards have this. They have a power-up with a little, like, in-game picture, as well as the profile. And then they've got the profile, and then a little quote from Phony. Withered Freddy's power-up is once per game, you may look at a card that one player has just shown another player. So pretty useful power-up right there. You can see the back. And I think this quote is, like, I'm sure you've noticed by now, the older model sitting in the back room. And then the final character that we're gonna look at is BB. His power-up is, once per game, you may move to any other room that does not have a secret passage. And then on the back, he's got his little face here, as well as a quote from Phony. Not even about Balloon Boy, just about the toy characters in general. So I'm guessing these are the cards that you could pick up when you land on a little question mark on the board, or you roll a question mark on the die. Played it once, so I don't really know what I'm talking about. But on the back, it's got Purple Guy. If 8 Purple Guy cards are revealed, the game ends. Ooh. So here's another intrigue, and it's got the endoskeleton from FNAF 2. Man, good memories. The rumor stays unanswered. Play instead of answering a rumor. I guess that can be pretty helpful. Alright, so something that's weird is that for the intrigue cards, you can also sometimes get characters? Like this one, with a Barney. You can move anywhere, play immediately. I mean, I guess that's why he's not a playable character, but it's kind of weird that he's on a card instead. Another intrigue card, and we've got Golden Freddy. Take an extra turn. Play now or keep until needed. I never mentioned this, but all the cards are like this. Again, they have that same, like, paper clipping feel to them, and I really, really like that about this Clue game. So, this is one of the locations, party room number one. And because all the locations and items are the exact same, I'm just gonna show one of each. This is an item, and it's the puppet. Weirdly enough, it's the puppet and not the puppet's mask, even though that's what this is. And then we have cards for the players. Toy Barney's right here. It even has the color associated with that character on it.
Well guys, that's gonna do it for this review. Thanks so much for watching. Hopefully we can get around to playing this very, very soon, but who knows, I'm a very busy man. Just kidding, I just don't have friends. So again, thanks for watching. I really, really did enjoy this review. Honestly, this Clue, this Five Nights at Freddy's Clue, very nice. I guess this wasn't really a review, it was more of a showcase, but whatever. Again, thanks for watching, and I'll see you all on the flip side. Goodbye.